Hello, I'd like to show you how to use weighted finite state automatons to solve some kind of puzzles. This puzzle is from the game I Have One Day, and it's some kind of wolf-goat-cabbage problem. That means here we have four people. The four people like to walk through the fog to reach that cave, but they have some kind of lantern or torch that shines through the fog. But it shines only for two people, so only two people can walk at once through the fog, but all four want to reach the cave. And the four people, some of them are slower than others, and when two people walk through the fog, they take as much time as the slowest of both takes. And why we use weighted finite state automatons is that we want to find a solution where those four people reach the cave in the fastest possible time. And that's exactly what weighted finite state automatons can do, because we can easily calculate the shortest path, that means the path with the least weight. And that's exactly what we want here. So the idea on how I create the weighted finite state automaton is, well, first I think of the states automaton has, and at the beginning all four people are on the left side. Well, and so I don't like to write that much, so I give them just some letters, and the letters are because of the names of the colors in German, because in German black and blue have different letters at the beginning. So this one is called S, this one is R for red, this is G, and this is B for blue. So at the beginning, all four people are on the left side of the fog. That means I write in the first state S, R, G, B. And I write some a pipe that tells me where the fog is. So all four people are on the left side and nobody's on the right side. And of course, there are different methods on how to create the automaton. I could include the torch here, or I could include the direction in which they walk, and well, but I just decided to do it this way. Then we have to add another state, and well, maybe one possibility is that I say S and R go first. So I add them to the arc, and they both need as much time as the slowest of both, and the slowest is the red one with 20 minutes, so I add a 20 here. And if they are on the other side, it means the yellow one and the blue one are left on the left side, and now the black and the red one are on the right side. So that's one possibility in the first step. Another possibility would be that the black one and the yellow one travel first, and the slowest one of both is the yellow one, which takes 1 hour and 40 minutes, so I add 100 as a weight. And if they are on the other side, then only red and blue are on the left side, and the black and the yellow one are on the right side. And the automaton will go much on and on, and it will take a lot of time to draw it all. So I just I just coded it in Python, which will help me to calculate the shortest path. So that's the code I have. Well, with comments in German, but when I edit in the video description, I will add some English comments for you. I use those OpenFST package that includes all the automatons. Here is where I create the automaton, and then I add the arcs. For example, here I add one. The arcs are not named like I did it here, because here the by default the states are named as numbers. So that is. State number 0, and it's state number 1, and state number 2. So, here I have an arc from 0 to 1, that is this one, where the black one and the red one travel first, that's like here, and the weight is 20. And that's what I did for all, or for nearly all possibilities, because I didn't include what happens when a single one of them travels first. And also I didn't include any backward passes. So, but when I did it all, then I have the last state that I declared as final state. And then I wrote a file that includes a definition of how the graph will look. And from that graph, the picture is created in the next step. But what's the interesting part is that here I have the function that generates or that calculates the shortest path. And that's what I also can write to a file and show you a picture of it. Well, and here I calculated the two shortest paths, and you will see in a while why I did that. So let's... Sorry. Let's just... let's have a look on the graph. That's the whole automaton, and if you can see here, that's my initial state, that's named 0. And here, if the black and the red guy travel first, then they take 20 minutes, and we are in state 1, and so on, until in the final state, all of the four people are on the right side of the state, of the fork. And then I calculated the shortest path, that's what you can see in this picture. And please not be confused by those strange numbers, but you can see the actual solution here. It says the shortest path is when black and red traveled first, and then red travels back, and then yellow and blue travel to the right side, and then the black one comes back alone and takes the red one with him, and then that is the shortest path. And maybe if you watched some walkthrough of the game, then you see that this is not the solution from the walkthrough. And that's why I calculated the two shortest paths, and please be not confused by all the epsilons here. And these are the two shortest paths, and as you can see, they only differ in that point where red travels first, and here black travels first, and here the black one travels last, and the red one travels last. And so these both shortest paths have the least weight. And the second path those algorithm gave me is the one that's from the walkthrough. So what was very interesting for me is that the puzzle actually has two best solutions. I hope to give you an idea on what you can do with white infinite state automatons, and of course it was, I had to draw the automaton on paper first so that I could create the code and be sure that I don't make any mistakes, but, well, actually it's a weighted finite state automaton that I draw, so you can use them to solve some puzzles. And I just wanted to give you an idea on what you can do with them.